Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Today, as I'm here eating my lunch and enjoying my favorite carbonated soft drink, it occurs to me that in all my recent travels around the world, this soft drink has always tasted the same. In this episode of Behind the Science, let's dive into the topic of consistency and controlling of quality in beverages. To shed light on this, I'm going to turn to our very own food rockstar, Joe Romano. Hi, Joe. How are you doing today?
Great. Hi, Jen. Great to see you.
Good to see you, too. So I know that you've done a lot of work on beverage analysis, and I love my carbonated soft drinks, and it always amazes me as I travel around the world the consistency of the taste no matter where I am.
Yes, beverage manufacturers go to great lengths to ensure the quality and consistency of the key ingredients in any geography. In fact, the quality control labs at these production facilities make sure that the additives such as preservatives, sweeteners, and caffeine are at the level that they should be and therefore provide consistency and give you the taste that you expect. Let me show you on the whiteboard how the process works.
That'd be great.
Okay. First, incoming process water is treated and filtered to produce high purity water. Syrup concentrate is then added along with a sweetener to produce a premix. Next, CO2 is added to create a carbonated beverage. A controlled beverage sample is taken from the premix for UPLC analysis of caffeine, sweeteners, and preservatives. If the ingredients meet the target range, the batch is sent on to the filling station to be packaged into bottles or cans.
Joe, that was so interesting. So what happens if they get an unexpected result?
Well, by minimizing the cost of an out-of-spec batch, a production facility can save approximately $24,000.
Wow, that's a lot of money. So it's definitely worth doing QC testing on it.
It sure is.
So my other question is that in this hand I have diet, and in this hand I have regular. It looks exactly the same. How can you tell the difference?
Well, let me take some samples and we can run it on our system and I can show you how we tell the difference.
Sounds good.
Okay, let's do it. And Jen, here are the results. First, we see a standard chromatogram which shows the preservatives, sweeteners, and caffeine from the analysis. In the second chromatogram, we see the diet cola, where we see the non-nutritive sweeteners, a preservative, as well as caffeine, which identifies the key ingredients in the diet cola. Now, for a regular cola, what we would see is the same profile, except the non-nutritive sweetener would be absent from the chromatogram.
I have a new appreciation for the quality control that goes into carbonated beverages. The kit, combined with the LC system, provides a robust Rockstar instrument that the QC lab can rely on. Now, every time I enjoy my favorite beverage, I know exactly what makes it taste so great all the time. Check out the links below to learn more about controlling consistency using the beverage analysis kit. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition.